You may be seated. Thank you. Hallelujah. Wow. What a wonderful atmosphere. I'm blessed. Awesome atmosphere. You have on your table the message for to take home. What an awesome atmosphere. Have it on the table. Wow, wow. Hallelujah. You listen to that song. The song have said it all. So the choir, will you please stand up and just give us the clue of that song? Read it, please. Hallelujah. Thank you. And we thank the sister is leading us for us to understand what she's saying. Wow.
Hallelujah. Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth? Matchless love and beauty, endless worth. Nothing in this world can satisfy. Jesus, you're the cup that won't run dry.
Listen to that. I think what the song is saying, all God have called you to be. All God has called you to be. Hallelujah. That is, be all God has called you. Tell your neighbor, be all God has called you. I can hear you. Wow. You remember last Sunday, last week, I was telling you that if you want to be all God has called you to be, you got to spend time with Him and learn from Him. Are you with me? If you want to be all God has called you to be, you got to spend time with Him and learn from Him at His feet. And learn at what? At His feet. The main things about Christianity, the main things about Christianity is not what we do. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. You spend all your time fasting, prayer, fine. You preach. You can go to, you can preach every day, 3 churches, 4 churches. They send you from one place to another. It's good, fine. You pay your tithe, fine. You sleep in the church, fine. All this, fine. It's not what we do, but the relationship we maintain. The relationship we maintain, and the atmosphere produced by that relationship. If you say you have relationship with God, that relationship must definitely produce an atmosphere. That is, what we do for God is only a reflection of the relationship we have with Him. What we do for God is only a what? A reflection of the relationship we have with God. Ask your neighbor, what are you doing with God? I can't hear you. What are you doing for God? What are you doing with God? What are you doing for God? What you do for God is only a reflection of the relationship you have with Him. What I'm doing is only a reflection of the relationship I have with Him. What are you doing with God? What are you doing for God? That son, really, the son is wonderful. It's wonderful. My, only you lead the son and sing it. Let's hear it. That's, we are going to be on our seat. Listen, I bless the singer. I bless the composer. I bless the composer and I bless the singer.
High, Jesus. Lift your name on high, Jesus.
And to have this the presence of God, you must have great relationship. Great relationship bring about great work, great presence. What we do for God, with God, what can you do for God? What can you do with God? What we believe today is, I'm working for God. That is our language. Instead of saying, I'm working for myself, I'm working for God. I'm an evangelist. I'm a Christian. I'm working for God. I'm a deacon, deaconesses, pastor, bishop. I'm an usher. I'm a Christ worker. I'm a salutation. I go to church. I'm in the church now. He says he's in the church for God. And because you don't have anything to do out there. If there's anything to do out there, there's no serious business today. If there's any serious business, I don't think you sit with me here. Or if you receive any phone call, very serious phone call, that is ready to pay you that $1 billion, you just walk out of this place. Just a phone call. Hello? Yes. Hello? Hello? They are ready to pay you that $1 billion. Oh, okay, hold on. Usher, please, where is the restroom here? He said, where is what? He's going to toilet. He's not going to toilet. He will now enter the toilet and say, hello, I can't hear you clear. You say what? He heard him clear, but you know, that language is our friend. I can't hear you clear. I say, they are ready to sign the check now. Where are you? I'm very close. But that is not close. It's not close. Very far. He says it's close because he wants to delay them. So, okay. Don't worry. Usher, okay. Just walk out. He's going. And why is this? So now the TV Dosha prayer has answered. If my prayer answered, will you leave me inside the church? I'll come back and give testimony. This church, we build it. We build it to the other side. No, the church is too warm. We need more air conditioning. I can buy a center AC. What we do for God or with God is only a reflection of the relationship we have with Him. Tell your neighbor. I can't hear you. What you do for God, you claim you do for God or do with Him or be whatever way. I'm an evangelist, I'm this, I'm that, I'm praying for you, I'm praying for this, I'm that, 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 I'm watching, I'm prayer body, I'm intercessor, I'm this, I'm that, whatever. You bring $3 million, I give it, donate it, this, that, that. You say you charity body, you help the needy, you help the widow, you give $3 million to support the work. For God's sake, all these are a reflection of the relationship you have with Him. If truly what you say you are doing for God, truly you do it for God. Because let's go to our Bible if we have just a little time, because the time is our factor now. Time is our factor. Are you there? Hallelujah. Are you there? So can we quickly look at Romans 8? Romans 8, verse 27. Now, he who searches the heart know what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saint according to the will of God. Take it again, verse 27. Now, he who searches the hearts know what the mind of the Spirit is. What does this mean? This means the mind of the Spirit means the Holy Spirit has a mind. When you say a road, mean there are many roads. But when you say the road, it means it's the only. This is a road, mean the other road. But the end different. Mean you say here that he who searches the heart know what the mind of the Spirit is. Means the Holy Spirit has a mind. When you now go to the 1 Corinthians 12, verse 6, it says, we have the mind of Christ. We have what? I can't hear you. I can't hear you. We have the mind of what? I can't hear you. We have the mind of Christ, that is the mind of God. So what we are saying now, when you search that verse 16, it says the mind of Christ is an independent mind. Satan is an independent mind. The mind that will think for itself. Are you there? The mind that will think for itself. Satan hates an independent mind. The mind that will think of himself, think for himself, that is the mind that is determined to find out from God the truth. What are you saying? It's a good listener, but he will listen to you, he will still find out from God before taking action. Satan will want you to take all you hear without question. Satan wants you to take what? Like before you come here, you know how you, the picture you look, the way you see this ministry. Before coming here, you say, oh, I must go there to see by myself. Coming here, you see differently. That is, if you have an independent mind that will think for itself, mind that is determined to find out from God truth, situation would not, you would not have said all sort of thing, I will, over my dead body, I will never step this place. Or rebuking a man and banding him some times ago, but today you are here because we are ready to take all without find out. Don't be afraid to say, I don't know, if you don't know. If you know, say, I know. That is the mind of Christ. Are you there? A person has the power of the power to decide. Let me put it this way. A person. I say, no, where am I going? Okay. Oh, where will I take? Is it here? I will take it. That is exercising the way through the mind. Exercising what? The way through what? The mind. Which one will I take? I will take it. The Holy Spirit has the power of choice. Holy Spirit has the power of what? Of choice. But you, the power you have to decide. Decide now. I'll take this one. This one, let me take this one. But the Holy Spirit have the power of choice. Yes. Now, how do we know who is speaking? When a pastor, because that name sometimes may be a title or a divine, if I come out and say I'm a pastor, I'm a prophet, I'm a bishop, and I begin to talk, how do we know who is talking? In the Bible, the Holy Spirit has a mind. Means there is also another mind. One can talk through. You see, the Holy Spirit has a mind. This show. Also, there is another mind. One can stand to say, Jesus is Lord. And this is not the voice of Holy Spirit. Jesus is Lord. This is the voice of Holy Spirit. How do we know the one that is voice of Holy Spirit and the one that is not voice of Holy Spirit? Be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. It will sound the same. Even the one that is not of Holy Spirit will sound better than the one that is not of, that is Holy Spirit. And when you hear it fluently, smoothly, oh, oh my God, on the outside, very smooth. But how do we know the voice of Holy Spirit in these two? Be he in Jesus' name. Be he in Jesus' name. We know the end, we know. Be he in Jesus' name. If the person is he, this is the voice of Holy Spirit. Be he in Jesus' name. If the person is not he, out of his unbelief. This can be said out of what? And this means a person is talking. A person is talking. A person is talking. Here we have a person has the power to decide. I'll go this way. I'll say this. I will not say this. I'll do this. I will not do this. A person has the power to decide. The Holy Spirit has the power of choice. Take note of these two words. That is, a person has the power of speech. Speech. S-P-E-E-C-H. The Holy Spirit speaks. You open the book of Acts 8. Let's look at what happened here. Acts 8, verse 29. I take. Then the Spirit said to Philip, Go near and overtake this chariot. So Philip ran to him and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah and said to him, do you understand what you are reading? Who is talking here? Who is talking here? I take it again. Then the Spirit said to Philip, go near and overtake this chariot. We all know chariot, that is mainly used in the olden days, but in the Western country they are still using them anyway. In some countries like Ethiopia, there's so many there. Many communities still maintain the olden ancient things. So Philip ran to him and heard him read the prophet Isaiah and said, do you understand what you are reading? This means a person has the power of speech. The Holy Spirit speaks as a word. We have the mind of God, the mind of Christ, an independent mind. Satan hates an independent mind, the mind that will think for itself. No. Okay, what are you saying? You say this, okay, like what I'm saying now, you listen to me. If you have an independent mind, you listen to me, you will now examine all what I have said. What are you examining it for? You want to know whether a person that talking or a prophet that is talking. There are two persons, a person and a prophet. You need to examine all this. That a person is talking to me or a spirit is talking to me. Because look at what I said. The Spirit said. Can you see we are hung, the Christian community, we are it seems we are all hung on the last day. If a change is not come, many Jesus will say, I don't know you. And if a change is not coming to Christian community, a change must come. Holy Spirit must intercede now, because it's getting worse. Because what is worse? Many of us are serving God we do not know. You don't know what I mean by serving God we do not know? God, you cannot hear from him, and he cannot hear from you. We believe so much in what we do with God and do for God, but we never believe, we never know that it's mere a reflection of the relationship we have with him. The Spirit of Father must come now and intercede before it is too late. And it's getting too late now in Christian community. It's getting too late. What I mean by getting too late, many are serving God they do not know. The greatest and the best answer to prayer, we believe that when you pray, God, heal me, and you are healed, that is the answer. There is another greater, best answer that's better than that. The best answer is for you to hear from God. When you begin to hear from him, you will begin to know God's opinion about yourself and about others. Look at what we are reading here. A person has the power of speech. The Holy Spirit speaks as he will. A person has the power to decide, where am I going? I will pray later. 6 o'clock, I will pray. Because of nightmare, let me go and pray. Because of attack I'm having, let me open my Bible and put it on that pillow. That is decide. You decide, not the Holy Spirit this time. You open your Bible, place it in your chest and sleep with it, because they are attacking you every day. A person has the power to decide. The Holy Spirit has the power of choice. Decide when to pray. 40 day, 49 coming. You know the time and when it will be. It's in the calendars. What we do with God, what we do is only a reflection of the relationship we have with him. A person has the ability to preach, to teach, ability to preach. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, amen. Ability to do it, we have it. We through the mind. The Holy Spirit teaches, preaches, counsels, witnesses, testifies as he will. So the son, what a wonderful son. Give it once again. Give it this once again. I bless the singer and I bless the composer. I'm not trying to advertise the son, I'm not the author. But when you say wonderful thing, you say, oh, you bless the, bless them. And the presence of God come by relationship with him. And the beginning of our message, the main things about Christianity is not what we do. Tell your neighbor, the main thing about Christianity It's not what we do. Whatever, I don't know what you do. So you pastor, you did, evangelist, you did, Christian, you do, pastor, you tight, you do. Well, just mention them. It's not what you do. But the relationship we maintain. The relationship with what? We maintain. The relationship we maintain. So whatever you talk of relationship present. The present your present is heaven to me. Okay, if the present is heaven to me, you are talking of atmosphere. Mean atmosphere produced by that relationship is heaven to you. You say, your presence is heaven to me. They talk of heaven to you, the present, you are talking of atmosphere. Under what atmosphere? That is, the atmosphere produced by that relationship is heaven. It's heaven. So please go and work on your relationship and stop deceiving yourself. I'm a pastor, I'm this, I'm that, I'm wasting your time sleeping in the church. It's a wasting of effort. Let us work on our relationship. Tell your neighbor, work on your relationship and stop deceiving yourself. I'm a Christian, I'm a pastor, I'm a prophet, I'm a bishop, I'm an evangelist, I'm a counselor, I'm a deacon, I'm a deaconess. Go and work on your relationship. Yes. Because all this title cannot take us to heaven. I'm a prophet. On the last day, God will not say, T.B. Joshua, prophet. He's a prophet. Allow him to enter. Which kind of prophet? It's relationship that will take you to heaven. Relationship with him that will take you to heaven. All this, I'm a pastor, I'm a prophet, I'm a deacon, I'm a deaconess, I'm a Christian, I'm this, I'm that, are symbolic. Jesus, the hope of glory. Tell your neighbor, work on your relationship. Work on your relationship. Work on your relationship. The atmosphere produced by that relationship will usher you to Jesus. So today it has become, we are now begin to use the name Christianity. People hide under this name. Christianity, hide under, I'm a prophet, hide under, I'm a bishop, I'm a deacon or deaconess, I'm a this, I'm that. We keep hide under that name, and because this is what people want to hear. People want to hear, I'm a bishop, I'm a prophet, I'm this, I'm that, I'm a Christian, I'm born again. Hide under this name. But tell your neighbor once again, the main things about Christianity is not what we do, but a relationship we maintain. That atmosphere, the atmosphere produced by that relationship will usher you. That is, will usher you to Jesus. So we have to work. That is the fundamental. You don't let anybody give you any title or any name. Work. Your work will give you that name. Leave that open. Leave the title open. God bless you. Hallelujah. Brother, can I talk to you?